Today, getting riggy with it. What's up, everybody? Anthony Saratelli of Jersey Filmmaker here, and welcome to another Road to Red episode. And today I want to talk about my shoulder rig setup that I use for my Red Raven and take you behind the scenes of a music video I recently shot with the very talented Whitney Wurz, a 16-year-old up-and-coming singer and soon-to-be star. The shoot was extremely fun and challenging at the same time. We only had 3 hours to get in, set up, shoot, break down, and get out. We shot it at Baza Studio in Long Island City, New York. The first challenge was that the studio was on the fourth floor and the elevators only went up to the third, which made for a nice workout that day. But once we were up, the fun began. We cleared out these couches so we could use this whole corner to give us that industrial exposed brick look. The day before, I went on a shopping spree at Home Depot and bought just over $1,000 worth of lighting and accessories so we had plenty of options to choose from. And as I anticipated, we used less than $100 worth of the lights and I returned the rest. My favorite and most anticipated option that I'm really happy worked out was dangling these makeshift Edison bulbs from the ceiling. I really wanted some sort of uplighting on the walls, so we decided to put some lights behind the guitars that we brought for decor, which I thought ended up looking really cool. We also threw some orange gels on the lights because I was going for that warmer look. It took about an hour and a half to set up and we immediately started rolling. Whitney pumped out 11 takes within an hour and we got right to packing up afterwards. We scrambled to get everything out of the studio and finally got the last piece of equipment in the car at the 3-hour and 15-minute mark. I'm extremely proud of what we accomplished in this small amount of time. I'm a huge pre-production guy and I love to have extra time on shoot days, especially if there's no day to run test shots. But I was asked to do this last minute and to keep the budget to a minimum, which definitely isn't uncommon, and like I mentioned, can be a really fun challenge. So big props to Whitney and her crew. They were a pleasure to work with, and she's extremely talented. I suggest you check out the full music video on her YouTube channel, which I'll put a link to in the description below. So moving on to my rig, let me start by noting that this is not customized specially for a Red camera. It's just a combination of rigging equipment I've collected over the years that I bunched together to fit whatever camera I'm using. So starting up front, I have these handles, which is from what's called the Composite Fiction Rig, made by Shape. I've had this thing for years, which I bought from my DSLR back when I first started, but now I just take bits and pieces of it to add to different rigs whenever I need. Underneath, we have this VCT Universal base plate, also from Shape. This big quick release plate secures the camera and obviously releases quickly. On the back, I have this Tilta V-mount Universal power supply plate. It obviously holds V-mount batteries and also has a P-tap, D-tap out, along with 3 other outputs for different voltages. And lastly, up top, I have this iCan articulating arm that holds my Odyssey 7Q Plus monitor recorder. I wouldn't normally keep this monitor over here, I just wanted to keep it out of the way so you could see everything. This is the exact setup I used when shooting this music video. If you look closely, you can see I don't necessarily put the shoulder pad on my shoulder because, as I mentioned, this isn't customized for a Red camera. So it doesn't work perfectly, but I make it work when I need to. You'll also notice that on this day I had my Red LCD monitor on the top here and leaning all the way forward. I prefer to have it on the side like I do now, especially when using an external monitor so I can see the monitor here and control the camera here. But I was having some technical difficulties that day with the LCD2 connection, so unfortunately I had to go topside. The biggest question I get asked is, why 2 batteries? I usually use a second battery only when I have an external monitor attached. I didn't run any cables here because I wanted to keep it clean so you guys could see everything, but I'd use this back battery to power the monitor. I do this because, one, the setup is big enough, so it's not like this is extending it all that much, and this battery is super light, so it's not adding a lot of weight. And two, this battery only runs the Raven for about an hour. If I were to power the monitor as well, it would significantly cut into the battery life, especially if you're recording externally as well. There are a couple more pieces that I add from time to time to fully deck this out, and they are a matte box and a follow focus. This is a Tilta matte box that I generally use when I'm outside, especially with the Red camera since there's no internal NDs. Also, it makes it look a lot cooler. It swings open for easy access to lens changes and you can slide the ND filters in and out. And lastly, I have this KameTV follow focus which attaches to the support rods and can be manipulated in many different ways to fit. So that's a couple ways I rig out my Red camera. I would love to see the way your rig is set up with whatever camera you use because I'm a nerd for this stuff. So post something on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook. I'd love to see what you got going and be sure to tag me at Jersey Filmmaker. If you like this video, please help me out by clicking the like button and subscribe so I can continue to grow and keep bringing you guys more and more cool stuff. I appreciate you watching. Enjoy the rest of your day and I'll see you next time.